If AI can create full episodes of South Park, can I create episodes of South Park and make money off of it? It's a fascinating question. Let's dig into it. This question is inspired by my friend who, after I sent him the video of the South Park AI video, he said, first, are you kidding me? Second, if South Park has intellectual property, then who makes the money? Can I make episodes and make money? It's a great question. So I want to first start off by looking at an analogy that happened a few months ago in the music industry. On April 4th, 2023, a TikTok user, Ghostwriter977, created this song called Heart on My Sleeve that had Drake and The Weeknd, and uploaded this song to Apple Music, Spotify, YouTube, various places, and it went crazy viral. Let's listen to it. Like Selena, the flex, ayy. Bumping Justin Bieber, the favor ain't left, ayy. She know what she need, all I need, all she blessed, ayy. Give it my best, ayy. So for those of you who don't know who Drake is a very popular worldwide hip-hop artist, and that sounds just like Drake. But Drake did not sing this song. So some people misinterpreted that AI made the whole song, and now people can just click a few, you know, keys, and then they can make a new song. That's actually not the case. This video by Aiden Kenway goes into detail of how it was created. Let's look.
This was me recreating the vocals. Singing Drake songs, you want it to be like, you're getting a lot of noise coming through this, like the top of your mouth. His voice is very nasally. I am Drake. You'll hear it like, I came in with my ex like Selena to flex, ay. Bumping Justin Bieber, a fever ain't left, ay. She know what she need, oh I need, oh she bless. Anyway. So we're going to be uploading those vocals to an AI generator, which will convert the timbre of my voice into the likes of Drake. Once again, I definitely don't condone using this service. This is merely an educational video, and I don't want to promote this at all to anyone who doesn't want to get sued. So I uploaded my vocals, ran it through the program, downloaded it, and that's going to sound like this. I came in with my ex like Selena to flex, ay. Bumping
Justin Bieber, but a fever ain't left. So I think the key here is that AI generated music, it's not simply like what the example that I showed with South Park, just typing a few prompts and making a few songs. That may happen in the future, but right now, the way AI music is made is there needs to be a singer that emulates a style of the AI artist and of the original artist and creates the beats and everything. So there's actually a lot of work that goes into this. Aiden talked about how in this video, he spent close to 18 hours trying to get it right. So that is an important note that there is a degree of hard work and creativity that needs to go in order to create a song like this. With that being said, this went viral. And then the question is, what was the reaction by everybody? I want to talk about three different reactions. One from Universal Music Group, which is the parent company for Drake, that represents Drake and The Weeknd. The second one, I want to talk about the reaction from Drake himself. And third, I want to show the reaction from somebody else that I think has a really interesting way of interacting with AI collaborators. First off, Universal Music Group. As you can tell by the headline of the title saying there's a fundamental responsibility to prevent the use of their services in many ways that harm artists, they were not happy with it. They were understandably not happy about it, about copywriting the voice of their artists. And they basically went to all the streaming platforms, Spotify, Apple, and issued a takedown saying, take down that music that is illegal. So that was their response. Unsurprising. Next, let's take a look at what Drake's response was. So Drake also did not really like the emulation. Somebody created a cover of him of Ice Spice's Munch, which is another song, and he basically said, this is the last straw. So he didn't really like it. Now, let's look at a third reaction, which I thought was really interesting. So Grimes is a music artist that's very well known for being the former partner of Elon Musk, but She's very open to AI. She's very kind of tech forward in that way. And this is what she wrote. I'll split 50% royalties on any successful AI-generated song that uses my voice. Same deal as I would with any artist I collaborate with. Feel free to use my voice without penalty. I have no label and no legal bindings. So her approach is that the technology is out there. People are going to use her voice anyway. Might as well get some money from it. And I think that's a very forward thinking and very interesting and maybe the right approach. People, she can't collaborate with everybody in the world, but she's essentially kind of putting it out there. And now there's going to be a lot of junk that comes out of it. But out of some of the songs, there may be some really amazing songs that really inspire her as well. And it does really well and it goes viral. In that case, all she's saying is, hey, it's fair that you're using my voice. Let me get my cut and you get your cut. And I think this is very interesting because it creates, instead of trying to play whack-a-mole and try to take down all the illegal AI-generated videos, it creates a business model where it aligns the incentives between the artist and the collaborator. And so I think it's just so strong. And there's actually an interesting analogy that's related to this that's been there in the past. In the late 90s and early 2000s, there was a service called Napster, which was a way of sharing files between two clients, so peer-to-peer. So I could have a version of a song and I could share it with one individual and you basically open this up so now you can get you can illegally download music. So the music industry obviously was not very happy about this and they started issuing takedowns and going after Napster, etc., right? So what happened was people wanted songs, but this was being done in an illegal fashion. So what happened next? A solution came out with a better business model. This is a great article that goes over the historic iTunes deal that was done in the early 2000s with the five major music labels. And basically what Steve Jobs was able to do was convince the five major music labels, hey, a lot of these peer-to-peer competition like Napster are stealing your music. Let me provide you a business model where you can retain your kind of ownership and get paid for your artists. And also we can get the consumers the songs that they want. So they moved to this this new subscription service, etc. But the point was Steve Jobs figured out a great business model that worked for both the consumers and the music labels, which was amazing. And because of that, the world changed. And then now you have subscription music such as like Spotify and iTunes or whatnot. So I thought this was a very interesting solution to the problem where people would just say, no, we got to take it down. Instead of that, they created a way to create a good solution for both the consumers and the music labels. So this is why we come back to Grimes, and I want to connect this all to South Park. Grimes is saying, look, this technology is out there, let's connect. And so it's inevitable, but let's find a way that creates a win for the artist, which is Grimes, and she gets her 50%, a win for the collaborator, 50%, and a win for the consumer who just gets better music. So now, connecting that with South Park episodes and TV episodes, I see a very kind of similar analogy. I can see technology-forward studios saying, look, you're going to have access to our content. We give you access. If you say anything negative or illegal or, you know, just hate speech or anything like that, then we can definitely take that down. I think that is definitely reasonable. But if you can collaborate and create a really great series of South Park episodes or a bunch of Simpson episodes that are really creative, we get 50%, you get 50%, and then the consumers also get a great new remix. And actually this helps the studios because it brings back interest in their shows. So I think kind of a broader thing that I think is really interesting is that The Simpsons, South Park, a lot of these TV shows, they can only talk about certain topics. But if suddenly it is democratized and now anybody can talk about whatever they want, that means that a lot of people's stories who the mainstream media has never really cared about or the entertainment industry hasn't really cared about, their voices can be heard. What about a Korean-American kid who wants to move to Korea? Will people cover that story? I don't know. I can just see all these different stories that are going to start coming out, which will be super interesting. And they don't need to be backed by a big studio. They could just create a video, upload it on YouTube, and the studios get their cut, the collaborators get their cut, and the consumers are given access to a whole new world. So I think it could be a net positive, but I think definitely there needs to be some regulations and some rules around saying negative things, hateful things, illegal things, stuff like that. So I am not an expert in this field, but these are just some of my thoughts. I would love to learn from y'all and see what y'all think. Please leave your comments below. Thanks for listening. Bye.